when you're running Google Ads, you want them to succeed and you want them to be profitable. And your audiences, they are such a crucial part of a successful campaign. And I'm often asked, what's the difference between an in-market audience versus affinity audience? And in today's video, I'm going to show you what an affinity audience, Google Ads audience is, and what an in-market audience is, and why they're so important, and how you can use them to generate top of funnel, pre-qualified, and middle of funnel, very warm leads for your business to be successful. Hey everyone, I'm Richard Cruz. My agency tests and develops cutting-edge Google Ads strategy every day. And in these videos, we share with you the best tips and strategies that we're discovering so they can help you, that you get better results with your Google Ads campaigns. But before we get started, click on the subscribe button if you'd like to get free Google Ads tips updates sent to you on a regular basis. The difference between an in-market audience versus affinity audience is lifestyle versus a shopping window. In market is a specific audience that Google makes available to you and is telling us that they are looking for your product or your service right now. And if you'd like to get your product or service in front of them, you can. And if you don't have a list, in market is the hottest audience that you can go after. And I think what's so awesome about it and why it's so important, it is absolutely low hanging fruit. It is the middle of the funnel traffic. Middle of funnel means it's a marketing term. People who are not cold leads, right? Your top of funnel is your cold traffic coming in. They've never heard of you before. It's the hardest to convert. It's the most expensive to go after. When they've shown activity, behavior, engaged, they've shown some interest, that is your middle of the funnel. Oh, that is like the precious part. You want that middle funnel to be as big as possible. And that is a audience that if you take good care of it, you bring it into your bottom of funnel and you make it a customer. And that audience is just one step away from becoming your customer. So you really want to make sure that your in-market audiences, that these are very strategic in the way that you're going after them. So how does Google really know? And I get this asked this all the time, how these people really are in market for your product or your service. Well, Google, they have the most sophisticated data gathering system on the planet Earth. They have billions of touch points in their algorithms and are able to determine buying behavior with an extreme level of accuracy. Every Google search, YouTube video viewed, text, social engagement, telephone conversations, Google Maps, tracking places we go, routes that we travel, it's pretty fair to say that they have more and better data than anybody on Earth. And so why not use their data that they're gathering for you so that you can generate new customers for your business? So for these in-market audiences, the data is as fresh as within the last 14 days. And let me show you in the Google Ads Manager where you go and how you set that up. So looking right here, as you're setting up your campaigns, obviously you're going to go in and you're going to type in, you know, your goal and your campaign name and your networks and all of these areas right here. This is the part that a lot of people miss because this is all you see when you're setting up your campaign, this tiny little line. And so often I just see people skip it 100%. They never even wind up using it. You have to remember to click down in here and you're going to go to this section right here. And another thing as well too, is that you have two options. You have either set it for targeting or for observation. So if you set for targeting, you're going to narrow the reach of your campaign to the selected audiences with the option to adjust bids. However, if you set for observation, then you're not going to narrow the reach of that campaign, and you have the option to adjust the bids, you know, on the selected audiences. So I recommend going with observation. Google recommends going with observation. So make sure that you have this box, it's checked, and this would be both on your in-market versus and your affinity. And so when you're coming in through here, you've got your search, your ideas, and your browse, and right in here you're going to see them grouped together, and your in-market is right in here, and this is where you're selecting. So baby and children's products, and so right here, baby and children's apparel, and then you're able to drill down, and let's just say that it's baby and toddler apparel. And if that's your market, you're now starting to build your audience list right here that is an in-market audience list. Now, if you're going for affinity as well too, and I recommend that you use them both, this is now where you're able to bring in your affinity audiences as well too. One of the cool features, and it's not used a lot, and so you want to make sure that you really use it, is you can put in your website, or you can put in two or three of your major competitors' websites, and Google will scour the keywords and be able to bring up a really nice list here of both in-market and affinity audiences that you can use. So that's where you go, you know, for affinity long-term audiences. So an example of an in-market person would be somebody who is searching for a, say, personal injury attorney. And when they go to Google and they're typing in personal injury attorney near me, there's a strong chance that he's going to be hiring an attorney soon. So you want to make sure that your ad is very, very strong. And I'm talking about in market right now. Okay, I'm going to get to affinity in a moment. So your page really needs to carry the scent from that keyword into the ads in both the headlines and the description into the landing page. And so that you're highly relevant to that shopper, you want to have a relevant experience. Remember, that's your hot, hot shopper right now. You do not want them looking around at other places. You want to stop them, bring them into your campaigns, and you want to turn them into a customer. So in in-market audiences, we really find huge success with remarketing. Your remarketing should be so well dialed in for in-market, because remember that they're middle of funnel, they're ready to buy. And when we set up ads for in-market, we like to use a point system to identify hot leads that don't contact you, and remarketing on display. And by the way, don't just retarget display with banners, use video. You can use video for remarketing, and it is a powerful tool. Not a lot of people use it. And so you're really able to stand out and be able to draw them back. Make sure that your retargeting for in-market is also going to YouTube, Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter. Remember, they're a hot, hot, hot buyer, and they're in that short window of time, depending on what your industry looks like, and you don't want them to get away. You want to be able to reach that net out, bring them back, make them a customer of yours. Create that surround sound effect and get the sale. So now I'm going to switch back over to affinity audience. The affinity audience meaning purpose and strategy is what we're going to talk about. So an in-market versus affinity audience specifically is that your affinity audience is targeting a person's lifestyle or interest. So an example of an affinity audience would be a runner. He runs marathons. He's active and he's an avid fan of just running, and he's probably into fitness and nutrition and running shoes, apparel, sports gears, things like that. Your marketing approach needs to be a long-term approach for this guy here. So that's the difference when you're talking about your affinity audience. He may buy several pairs of running shoes throughout the year, every year, but he may not be in the market right now. So with this audience, I'm going to show you the best way to be able to approach it and really take advantage of it and have an automatic system that brings them from top of the funnel to middle of the funnel. So what we like to do with this is do a lot of branding. We use top of the funnel video, for example, and what we do there is we'll let relevant YouTube video ads run and we'll target these affinity audiences. And those people that actually stop and watch the video to a certain percentage, or they click through on the video, tells us how much and how little that they're in the market right now. And so those that are not in the market, they're not stopping in the video, they're not watching the video. We just let them run right on by. And so you can run video for pennies per view. It is so cheap because a lot of people aren't using video. And so you can keep your brand out there to be seen over and over and over again so that you've got market share, mind share that you're buying with these running audiences or whatever your audience is. And so video is so powerful with that. I'd like you to also pair it with display as well too. So when you're running video and display, you have a lot of brand and awareness out there and your name. It's like having billboards all over the place. It's like, you know, if you're a baseball fan and you're in the World Series and you're advertising and you're out in the outfield fence, you're, you know, up on the scoreboard, you're everywhere. That's the same thing, right? You're getting your name in front of them. And so when they click on any one of your ads, on any one of your videos, they watch the videos, they're identifying themselves as being active and interested in what you're advertising. So this is a super, super hot lead. And it's even, in my opinion, it is better than in-market audiences because they've seen your brand for a while. They know you, they like you, they trust you, and now they're clicking on your offer. So your conversion rate is going to be among the highest of all of your campaigns if you use good affinity audience targeting strategy. So when you're setting up here in your campaigns, one thing that I want you to do is make sure that you do not combine your affinity audience or even your in-market audience with keywords. And so when you're setting all of this up right here, keep those separate. This is a mistake that I see made so often that you'll pollute it and it's hard to tell which audiences are actually your winners and your losers. Using market audiences and affinity audiences without those keywords, test the Google Ads ad groups against each other to find the winner. And if one of your affinity audience Google Ads campaigns is outperforming the other one, then put more budget in that one and reduce the other. Same for your in-market audiences, of course. And that is the difference between an in-market audience versus an affinity audience. I hope that you've learned at least one thing in this video that can help you with your marketing. If so, tell me what that one thing was. Put it in the comments below. Your feedback, it helps me to make better videos later on. And don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, share it, subscribe so that you're alerted to future training videos like this. Thank you for watching.